This dentist refused to perform root canals for over 20 years. This is the reason why. For an adult, a root canal is a common procedure. It might seem like a wise choice because it helps treat and also protect any tooth that has become toxic. Thankfully, Dr. Robert Kulacz, a dentist and author of the book The Toxic Tooth, How a Root Canal Could Be Making You Sick, has done extensive research to answer the question, is it wise to get a root canal? Kulacz stopped performing root canals in 1995. He doesn't believe that they need to ban root canals, but he does believe that there needs to be some informed consent. The American Dental Association states that root canals are safe procedures and cannot cause diseases. But Kulacz's research proves otherwise, which is why he stopped performing root canals. Before we begin this video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button for more daily tips like this, and turn on notifications so you never miss our new videos. Now, let's analyze why Dr. Kulacz has refused to perform root canals for over 20 years. What is a root canal? The Canadian Dental Association defines a root canal procedure as the process of removing an infected, injured, or dead pulp from a tooth. When bacteria enter your tooth through deep cavities, cracks, or flawed fillings, your tooth can become abscessed. An abscessed tooth is a tooth that has become infected with pulp. If this pulp becomes infected, doctors will recommend that it needs to be removed. If it's not, it can cause pain and swelling. When a tooth is badly damaged, a dentist will first take an X-ray of the affected tooth to examine the damage and the extent of the decay or infection. If the damage is manageable and can be fixed with a filling, the dentist will complete a filling. However, if the damage is so severe that a filling cannot save the tooth, the dentist will advise you that you require a root canal to remove the damaged pulp from the tooth. When root canals are performed, local anesthesia is placed on a tooth and a pulpectomy is performed. A pulpectomy is performed when a dentist drills an opening into a patient's tooth. The dentist removes the damaged pulp, and once the pulp is removed, he or she will fill the root in and seal it with cement. Once the root canal is completed, a follow-up appointment is scheduled to ensure that the tooth is healing properly and that the infection is gone. Your dentist will also give you an aftercare routine to ensure that your tooth properly heals and that you are not at risk for another infection and another possible root canal for any of your other teeth. One commonly held misconception about a root canal is that it is a painful procedure. This is why many people fear going for the procedure. Root canals are actually no more painful than your regular filling. The pain associated with root canals are actually caused by the infection and bacteria in the tooth itself. When the pulp becomes damaged, it becomes extremely painful. The root canal procedure itself is what removes the damaged pulp, which removes the pain. A root canal is a procedure which is completed to remove and help ease the pain. Root canal bacteria can worsen other diseases. Because a root canal tooth is technically infected, it can contribute to certain health problems, which include heart disease, according to Kulacz. He says that heart diseases are generally caused by damage to the inside lining of the blood vessel and migration and macrophages and cholesterol inside that artery. The inflammation in the artery causes plaque to rupture into the space of the blood vessel. This causes a blood clot and a heart attack. This same bacteria that is found in root canal teeth and gum disease is also found in plaques of coronary arteries in the blood clots, says Kulacz. The plaque travels from the mouth to the other sites of the body. Keep watching for some even more interesting reasons that Dr. Kulacz avoids performing root canals. And keep watching until the very end to find out what types of alternatives there are to root canals. Root canal teeth can get infected over time. Kulacz explains that because root canal teeth no longer have a blood supply, the bacteria is essentially hidden from the immune system. What's worse is that the root canal can become more infected because of the influx of bacteria from the gum tissue that is surrounding the tooth. Necrotic tissue can cause problems. When someone gets a root canal, the tooth is no longer alive. This means that it should never be left in the body. Take appendicitis, for example. The doctor doesn't just isolate it, he completely removes the appendix. Unfortunately, when it comes to a root canal, this rule is not applied, according to Kulacz. He adds that when patients came to him as a last result, their chronic health issues were resolved once he removed their root canal and the infection was treated. How to avoid a root canal? According to Main Street Dental Clinics, there are a few ways you can avoid having root canal treatments. The first way is to maintain a healthy diet. According to Ramil Nagel, the author of Cure Tooth Decay, the human body can protect itself from infection when we consume food that keeps our body balanced. According to Colgate, yes, that Colgate, eliminating sugars from your diet and replacing them with fruits and vegetables also helps. Another way to avoid a root canal is to maintain a strict diet and diligent oral healthcare routine. Not only does this mean avoiding overeating sugar, but it also means brushing and flossing your teeth twice daily and going in for a routine dental checkup at least once every 6 months. By maintaining a strict oral healthcare routine and going in for regular dental checkups, you can ensure that your oral health is in good shape. By going in for regular dental checkups, your dentist can also find issues before they turn into bigger problems and provide any treatment if necessary. Your dental health is extremely important. Never take it for granted. If you fear that you have an infected tooth or any type of tooth damage, consult with your dentist. By doing this, you can spot and address any issues with your oral health early on, and potentially save you from what could be very costly treatments in the future. Brush with toothpaste containing fluoride. The Carlson Biological Dentistry states that brushing your teeth every day with fluoride toothpaste can help scrub away the bacteria that is causing cavities. Fluoride gives your teeth extra protection against decay. Fluoride is a mineral that strengthens the protected enamel of your teeth. They state that if you can keep your enamel strong, you can prevent acids that are produced by oral bacteria that eat into the inner parts of your tooth. Root canal alternatives. If your dentist has advised you that you need a root canal but you are hesitant about going through with it, there are other alternatives and options. Depending on how severe your infection is, your dentist may go over other options with you in the event that you would prefer not to get a root canal. Speak to your dentist today to find out what other options you may have and what course of treatment is best for you. Of course, you should always take preventative measures to ensure that your oral health is in tip-top shape. It's best to do what you can to avoid root canals altogether. So speak with your dentist today to find out how you can improve your oral health. Extraction. One alternative to a root canal is an extraction. When a tooth is extracted, it is completely removed from a patient's mouth. This form of treatment is not usually performed unless the tooth is so severely damaged that it cannot be saved any other way. It is often used as a last resort in the event that the tooth cannot be saved with any other type of treatment. Dental bridges. In the event that a dentist determines your tooth needs to be extracted, you may want to consider dental bridges. Dental bridges help to close the gap between two missing teeth. They are made of multiple crowns, which are found on either side of the gap around an artificial tooth. There are several different types of dental bridges. The most common type of dental bridge is called a traditional dental bridge. Traditional dental bridges consist of one or multiple fake teeth. These fake teeth are placed in between dental crowns. Cantilever bridges. these bridges are very similar to traditional bridges, but are supported by a crown on just one side. Maryland bridges. Maryland bridges are held in place by a piece of framework made of two wings of metal on each side of a crown. Implant-supported bridges. Implant-supported bridges are used to support multiple gaps in a person's teeth and are supported by dental implants rather than dental crowns. Pulp capping. Pulp capping is a type of procedure which is used to seal off the entrance of a tooth's pulp. The tooth's pulp is sealed with sealant and is meant to save the pulp from dying. This type of procedure can remove the bacteria and/or decay in a patient's tooth, but may not always be successful. What are some other reasons you wouldn't want to get a root canal? Let us know by commenting below. Enjoyed this video? Hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this, and thanks for watching!